We are going to take this house and tear everything out. Everything goes. Close out. I mean, the entire layout of the house would change.
Yeah.
Hey, look what I just uncovered under this paneling.
Wow, more wood.
It's so realistic looking, though.
I don't think there's anything we can save.
I do want to save that.
The pie safe for sure.
Yeah, this is original to the house. It's a cool piece.
I love this piece. And we need to replace the screens, and you'd have to build a new top too. We just need to get it out of here. I don't know if it'll even fit through the door though.
So once the walls comes down, we'll drag this out.
Some real nice particle board. Oh man, I was really hoping we were gonna find something good.
We framed up the wall through the center of the house. It closed off all of those doors because they're not gonna be there. Now, there is gonna be one door through that wall from the foyer to the hallway, thus making a dog trot.
The dog trot door just does not exist yet. Yay, dog trot. It'd be a lot easier to trot through once there's no framing in the middle of the doorway, but.
Yeah.
At least the back of the house and the front of the house are connected now.
I love this cedar tree, but I would love it a lot better as the downtown Laurel Christmas tree. That's not why we're gonna take it down though. The homeowners actually want us to take it out. Miss Sandy is allergic to evergreens. Cedar's not as bad, but their daughter is like deathly allergic. She can't come to the house with this tree here. So we're gonna take it out.
All right.
How do we need to go about this?
First, we're going to get in there and take all those bottom limbs down so we can get in there and notch it and drop it toward the road.
That's awesome.
All right.
It smells like Christmas.
Except it's 80 degrees.
The bathroom door is already sketched out.
Yeah.
Door won't be there.
No, no door here.
Just a walk-in shower.
Shower.
Zero entry.
Zero entry, so you can just roll right in. This is the first time we've ever done this where we went in and totally gutted.
And then the first time we've built for aging in place. The doorway needs to be anywhere from 32 to 48 inches.
We're at 39.
Excellent. For aging in place.
So we need to start thinking about that for our house because...
We're not moving ever again.
I'm never moving, so...
I want this house to feel more like a classic Southern style house, but it's gonna be a little bit more formal than that, like Southern idyllic fantasy. So it feels right to have a wallpapered foyer, you know? Mm-hmm.
We have the best help today. My mom and daddy are here. They're gonna help me hang wallpaper.
Miss Sandy loves pattern and especially blues and whites. This,
it's an expensive wallpaper. The thing about expensive wallpaper is it has a real wide repeat. Less expensive wallpaper sometimes has a real close repeat, but these, it's almost like a mural.
Why did you choose such a tall wall?
It's what the house gave me, Daddy. It's looking really, really good. I didn't meet Grandpa Horse, but I know he'd be real proud of you.
Grandpa Horse's name was not Horse. His name was JT, but he worked so hard, they say he worked as hard as a horse. So. Grandpa Horse was a painter and a wallpaper hanger. Spit his tobacco juice in the paint, but he'd mix it real good so you couldn't tell.
The wall would start out white. Before we finished the room, it was beginning to get a little tone to it.
A little dinge would wrap around the room and get darker and darker.
Horse is a horse, of course, unless the horse is the famous Grandpa Horse.
It is so gorgeous.
I think the kitchen is the star of the star house.
And the cabinetry is really beautiful because we've got painted and then natural alder wood. I mean, the kitchen's huge. So if everything were the same color, I feel like it would have just fallen flat.
One, two, three.
And since Jack is so tall, we raised the countertops 2 inches.
This is a lot of pattern and a lot of color. But it's such a big kitchen, you can get away with it.
Yeah, and I love that sink. Wanted it to feel like furniture. And the way your sink steps out in the way a dry sink would have 120 years ago. This looks great.
Welcome to the Star House.
I'm speechless. This is wonderful. It is.
I think when people think of what it's like to live in the South, this is the picture they see in their mind. I just love that we were able to get this house balanced and symmetrical, because before you had three bizarre front doors.
Look at that front door.
The door is excellent. The shutters by the side of the doors.
That I like.
Yeah.
That really makes a statement.
It does.
Oh, that whole left side is all opened up now. That's wonderful.
This is truly a wraparound porch.
360 degrees.
I want to sit on that porch today. I don't care if it's 30 degrees out.
I made you a wind chime.
Really?
With a star on it. Perfect.
Yes. And a guy in my shop made another wind chime.
They're both made from just trash from the house.
Excellent.
Wow.
Excellent.
But we cut down the massive cedar tree.
Which is now in downtown Laurel.
Is it? We did see a tree down.
The one in the park.
We went by there yesterday and thought, nah, that can't be our tree. That's too big.
Come on, let's go in.
Oh, wow.
This is beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
Remember before how dark it was?
Oh. It was terrible. I like the color.
I know you love blues and whites. Because we made this a dog trot style house, you've got to have this grand entrance. And in a grand southern home, that entrance has got to have wallpaper.
Right. I think it's wonderful.
That's the old pie safe, Sandy.
It is.
Wow.
It ended up breaking and falling apart. So I took the pile of rubble that was left. I made this.
It's gorgeous. And it has our blankets in it, Jack.
See, they had newspapers glued down?
Yes.
You see what movie?
Gone with the Wind.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. That was in there? That was
cool. Yeah, that was in there.
This is beautiful.
Because I know you collect blankets. I had my friend Miss Susie, who does quilting, make this just for you.
And
for
the colors are perfect.
Well, they go with the house.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
You're so welcome.
We got to see this kitchen.
Oh, wow.
It's gorgeous.
We made you a kitchen from scratch. You had a disgusting shag carpeted bedroom in here.
This is beautiful.
And no island, Sandy.
And look at this table. It doesn't whack my hips. It's about, you know, it's...
So it has two leaves in it. You can take them
out. Good. Oh, good.
This is beautiful. I love this.
I wanted to give you a feature tile just over the oven.
Oh, I could have that over the whole house. I love it that much. I'll be baking, putting on weight. I like to bake. I like to cook.
I like to eat. Is this a granite?
It is.
It is.
Also, we raised the countertops 2 inches.
This is nice.
This is great. Now I can't say I can't do the dishes.
Look at the view of your house from your kitchen sink.
I like the fact that the floors run through the house.
Yeah, they're so beautiful, but also feel like they could have been here originally.
Mm-hmm. It feels really, really nice.
Now I want to show you the master suite.
Ooh. Excellent.
Oh, Sandy, this is gorgeous.
It is. Wow. Oh my gosh, this is nice.
It was the gross pantry in the kitchen.
This is where the pie sink. In the front room, it was
it was right about here.
Oh.
Wow.
This is beautiful. I like the fact that there's room here.
There's enough room here for
to
sitting.
Sit. This is really nice.
Oh.
How about that?
That's gorgeous. Oh, man.
Look at this.
Zero entry shower.
Oh.
Yeah. Glass door.
It's got a little of a slant. It's a slope, so the water will drain.
Will drain. Oh my gosh, this is nice.
Shower head's nice and high. Thank you.
Yes, you're very welcome.
Yeah, that makes a difference.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
It's beautiful.
I think we're going to enjoy this.